Have you ever seen a map legend with a whole bunch of unique values, so many that it's almost unreadable and unusable? Well, now with the map viewer, you can sort and organize your unique values into groups. Let me show you how. I found some land use zoning data from my hometown of Burnaby, BC on ArcGIS Online. Let's change the style based on the zone code type using unique values to see all the different zone types in the city. And I will add all the values to the legend. As you can imagine, there are a lot of zoning designations, to the point where the legend is difficult to interpret and understand. Let's go back to my style options and take advantage of adding groups in the map viewer. Just click on the little up arrow button next to a zoning type to move that value into a new group. So for example, I will add an R type to create a new group for residential zones. Scroll down to the new groups and rename those group names to something a little more meaningful. Here I am changing names for commercial and agricultural groups. Then drag other unique symbols into each group. Here I am dragging other R zones into my new residential group. There's a lot of grouping and renaming and dragging to be done to get this the way I want. So let me grind this out and see where this can go. Now this is more like it. I have sorted and arranged my unique symbols into proper zoning groups in my preferred order. I still have a little bit of work to do, but it will be a lot easier to change the symbols and rename the zones to match my corporate standards. Let me grind some more to glam this up even further. Boom! Here's my finished web map. The legend in the map viewer looks great. The symbols and names are set for each zoning type and are nicely organized into their groups. By grouping your categories, your web maps provide more detail and context. Your legends are now more legendary.